Honorable Minister Stier colleagues, greetings from Brussels. We are on the brink of COP26 negotiations and the call for ambitious climate targets is stronger than ever. The European Union has responded to this call by increasing its greenhouse gas emission reduction target from 40% to at least 55% by 2030. Investments in energy efficiency and renewables are key to deliver the Paris Agreement while also securing our energy system and lowering energy bills. This is why we have put forward a proposal to reach at least 40% of renewables in our energy mix by 2030 and increasing our energy efficiency target to 36% for primary energy consumption. This means doubling our annual renewables capacity additions from 30 gigawatt last year to at least 60 gigawatt annually in the next 9 years. And this, in turn, means doubling the investment needs, a situation which I believe is similar in the Asian region. Like elsewhere in the world, the COVID crisis has had a negative impact on the European economy. But we should take this as an opportunity to build back better. The European Post-COVID Recovery Fund requires its member states to invest at least 40% of the new financing into climate action. For the EU's long-term budget, this figure is 30%. But public finance alone is not sufficient. Overall, annual energy investments in 2021 to 2030 will need to increase by almost 400 billion euros per year compared to what we invested in the decade up to 2020. To facilitate private investment, we have introduced a taxonomy that puts in place strict criteria for projects and activities that are truly delivering sustainability. This will not only protect private investors from greenwashing, but help companies to become more climate friendly and help shift investments where they are most needed. Today, you are gathered in Singapore, a great example of creating stable economic growth with a strong manufacturing industry and finance sector. The ASEAN region has put forward a joint cooperation plan to support new sustainable investments in energy. The EU and ASEAN are equally concerned about energy security, sustainability, affordability and connectivity amongst their respective member states and ensuring a just transition for all. I hope to be able to visit you soon and discuss these issues and our cooperation in more detail. Thank you for your attention.